conversation with Tucker for a brand new episode of Tucker Carlson Today.
So the reality is that I think most Twitter accounts are anonymous.
Yes.
To start with.
Yes.
Unless you're a public official or, you know, a figure.
Unless you have the verification.
Well, not anymore.
Yeah,
Elon
right.
That. But until Elon changed that, you know, most Twitter.
They're talking about behind the account Libs of Liberty. How she never revealed her face.
You know,
well, here she is.
Growing, I realized the hatred that the left has and their violent nature. And I was like, I'm going to remain anonymous.
Yes.
As my account was growing and getting more effective. And I have remained anonymous until now. Until I was doxxed, my name was shared. My location was shared. My photo was never shared, but I've never done any in-person events. And I'm choosing to do that now because I feel like over the past few months, I've done so much. I've helped educate
so much damage.
I know that I've helped create legislation to tackle some of these issues. And I think I've done all I can. And I am ready for the next step. I get people asking me, I have mom groups asking me all the time, can you come help us? I get invitations, you know, to help people understand how to
expose you feel so special.
And, you know, being anonymous was sort of keeping me, I was restrained from doing all those things. And I'm ready to do that. I think that I'll be a lot more effective when I'm not so anonymous anymore. And I'm excited. I already have a couple of speaking engagements planned for the next few months.
Good.
And, you know, hopefully there will be more, but I want to do all I can and help people to fight this agenda.
And I'm glad that you are. I think it's an act of bravery. And you've had a remarkable effect. I just want to say, and I'll say this another 10 times because I think it's the most interesting part about you. You haven't really editorialized very much. What you've done, essentially, is bring to further light, to publicize what they're already saying in public. That's your crime.
Yeah, exactly. They don't want it to be shown out to certain audiences. They want their content out there, but they don't want us to see it. So it doesn't really add up.
No, it doesn't add up. And they have no valid complaint against you.
Right.
You haven't violated anyone's privacy. You're posting what they put on TikTok.
They're allowed to post it, but we're just not letting notice. The crime is noticing what they're doing.
Yes. That's always the crime.
Yeah.
So I think you've done an amazing thing, and unlike so many other people in journalism, and I'm going to, whether you like it or not, describe you as being in journalism, because I think you are.
I think I am, too.
You've had an effect, a real effect, by bringing this to light. How did you wind up, to the extent you're comfortable sharing it, like, how did you wind up doing this? I assume you went to Columbia Journalism School to become a journalist?
I went to Harvard and Yale. thank God I did it, though, because those are now, obviously, those institutions are all poisoned. So it started really during COVID. I was noticing all of this content that was being published on TikTok, and I was just like, this is crazy.
So are you.
You're not in a related field like you were.
No.
You're not doing anything related to public policy or journalism.
Nothing related to politics, journalism, no. Media,
were you
nothing.
Very political?
No.
Really?
I was not. Because
COVID was like the other day. This was just a couple years ago.
Yeah, this was 2 years ago. Well, my account started 2 years ago. Yeah.
That's just incredible that you can have this effect this quickly. So you're not a super political person, you're not watching people's speeches on C-SPAN.
No,
you're just a normal person stuck inside.
Exactly, and then COVID happened. And I think that COVID, for me, and I think for a lot of people, it really woke people up. And it was sort of, it was like an awakening. Either you can stay sleeping, you know, not really interested in what's going on in our government, or you can choose to get involved. And I think COVID really drew a lot of people in just because of all of the insanity that was going on and that was being imposed on us. Our rights were being violated. And I was like, and that was really, uh, that was really a turning point for me to get involved and to be interested. And then COVID also is when TikTok started becoming big, because everyone was stuck at home looking for entertainment. And then they stumbled on TikTok, and we started seeing all those videos of nurses, you know, dancing in hospitals during the pandemic. And I was like, you know, TikTok was getting really big, and I was like, oh, you know, let me see what this TikTok thing is all about. And then I stumbled.
It's crap. That's what it's all about.
This whole platform with all of the stuff, you know, everyone I'm sure has seen some of the videos.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.
I need to disseminate this. Like, it's just so bizarre and dangerous.
And thank you to all the new subscribers.
As many people to see this as possible.
In large part, not exclusively, but there's a lot of adults bragging about sexualizing children.
Yes, a lot. Specifically teachers. There are also just parents, activists, doctors. That is the most scary part about it, and that's what my account focuses on a lot now.
Gosh, what an interesting conversation. I hope her stepping out inspires others to do
the same. Thank you. See you tomorrow. God bless.